Good morning, children. In Value Education, today we will study chapter number 8, The Little Prince. Let us begin with the chapter. Once upon a time, there was a king whose son was very conceited and ill-mannered. The prince was very unkind and cruel towards everyone. The king and his courtiers tried their best to make the prince understand that this behavior created a bad impression on the people, but the prince paid no attention to their advice. Okay, so there was a king who had a son who was very conceited, which means he was full of self-love and he was ill-mannered. He was very unkind and cruel towards everyone. The king and his courtiers. Who are courtiers? Courtiers are the person who attend a king's court. So the king and his courtiers tried a lot to make him understand that this behavior is not good. It creates a bad impression on people. But the prince paid no attention to their advice. Okay? One day, a sage came to the king's court. He carried a bowl in his hand for collecting alms, and he had a glowing face. The gait of the sage suggested that he was blessed with divine knowledge. So what happened? That one day, a sage came to the king's court. Who is a sage? A sage is a wise man. And he was carrying a bowl to collect donations. And his face was glowing. And the way he was walking, it suggested that he was blessed with sacred knowledge. He was blessed with holy knowledge. So the meaning of alms is donation. Gate means here, the word gate means the way of walking. The way sage was walking, it reflected that he was blessed with divine knowledge. Divine means holy or sacred knowledge. The king and his courtiers welcomed the sage with great honor. So the king and his men welcomed the sage with great honor. The king came to know that the sage was in search of a good dwelling for himself. So the king got to know that the sage, that the wise man, was searching for a good place to live for himself. The king immediately offered him a hermitage inside the place, and the sage accepted the offer. So when the king got to know that the sage was looking for a place to live, he immediately offered him a place to live inside his palace, and the sage accepted his offer. In their discussion, one day the king said to the sage, "You would have come to know by now that my son is very ill-mannered. He has no love or compassion towards anyone. The people of my kingdom call him an unworthy prince. They don't want him as a king. I beg you to reform my son." The sage assured the king that he would do his best to change the behavior of the prince. So one day what happened, that the sage and king were sitting together. They were discussing something. So in their discussion, there came up the topic of the prince. The king said to the sage that by now you would have come to know that my son is ill-mannered. He is conceited, and he has no love and compassion towards anyone. He doesn't love anybody. He doesn't respect anybody. And the people of my kingdom calls him an unworthy prince, and they don't want to see him as a king. They don't want my son as a king. And the king begged the sage to reform his son. And then the sage assured the king. He said that okay, he would try his best to change the behavior of the prince. Let us see what happened next. The next day, the sage took the prince for a walk through the garden of the palace. Pointing to a tiny plant, he said to the prince, "Eat a leaf of this plant and tell me how it tastes." So next day what happened? The wise man took the prince for a walk. They went for a walk through the garden of the palace. And then the sage pointed towards a tiny plant and asked the prince to eat a leaf of that plant and tell him how it tastes. The moment the prince tasted the leaf, he spat it on the ground. The sage said, "It seems to be a poisonous seedling. If it is allowed to grow into a big tree, it may prove dangerous for the health of many people." So what happened that as soon as the prince plucked the leaf and tasted it, he spat it to the ground. He threw it. And then the sage said that it seems that it is poisonous. And he said that if we allow this seedling to grow into a big tree, it might be very dangerous to the health of many people. The prince pulled the tiny plant out of the ground and tore it into pieces. So, hearing the words of the sage, the prince pulled out the tiny plant out of the ground and tore it into many pieces. Then the sage picked up that plant and said to the prince, "As you have reacted in case of this plant, the people of your kingdom may one day react in the same manner with you." So, the sage picked up the tiny plant and said very politely to the prince that, "See, the way you have reacted in the case of this plant, the people of your kingdom would also react in the similar manner with your case. They think that you are a wicked prince. They may not allow you to rule the kingdom. So, it's better that you mend your ways to generate feelings of mercy, compassion and kindness in your heart." And then the sage made him understand that the people of your kingdom thinks that you are an immoral prince. You are sinful and they may not allow you to rule the kingdom. They might not allow you to become the king. So, it's better that you mend your ways to generate feeling of mercy, compassion and kindness in your heart. Try to be polite. Try to be generous towards everyone. The prince understood the message of the sage. From that day on, he was a changed person. He made an honest effort to become a humble, kind-hearted, merciful and lovable to others. So these words of sage transformed him. The prince understood the message and then from that day he worked very hard and honestly to become humble, kind-hearted, merciful and lovable to others. So the moral of the story is, conceit is poison for the soul. The sooner you get rid of it, the more you earn honor and respect. Yes, which means that self-love is poison for the soul. The sooner we get rid of self-love, the more we earn honor and respect in the society. So that's all for today, children. Have a good day ahead.